Now it's time for a little segment we like to call Only in America. Well, how do you defend the indefensible? You know, some of the worst crimes you can imagine. Horrors so bad that I'd spend more time warning you about them if I was to describe them than I have for in this time in this segment. Well, it's all about advertising and public relations.
Hamas has brought us on to kind of help with their messaging. We kind of want to make them not look like terrorists.
But they are terrorists. They're more violent than ISIS.
Okay, boomer.
I got one. The word terrorist, a little icky. Mm-hmm. What if we call them freedom fighters?
Freedom fighters? Who doesn't love that?
Wait, they raped women and butchered innocent babies.
Yeah, for freedom.
Oh, I got one. You know how Hamas blatantly states their number one goal is to kill all Jews in the name of jihad? What if we made it more of a cute little catchy slogan?
How about, from the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
You're on fire this morning. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
Seriously, guys?
Keep it rolling.
There is only one solution. Antifada revolution.
Excuse me, the Intifada was a series of violent terrorist acts committed against Israelis and Jews in the late 80s and 2000s.
No, I don't think that's what Intifada means. Does anybody know what Intifada means? I thought it's like a Mexican dish, like empanada.
Aren't Palestinians Mexican?
I think so, I think so.
See, from the river to the sea, senor.
You know how Gen Z are all about that? Women's rights, gay rights. What if we make the terrorists the victims?
But Hamas literally kills gay people just for being gay, and women virtually have no rights in Gaza. They're monsters.
Monsters, Inc. Great movie.
Ooh. I don't know if that would work.
Colin, can you stop ethnically cleansing people's ideas, please?